Hello, today I'm just making a quick video. I'm updating my BIOS. This could either go terribly right or terribly wrong, due to the fact that if you do it wrong, then you're pretty much screwed. But I've got the pen drive in there, or whatever you want to call it. Oh shit, I need to get into... start over. I need to get into my BIOS. So at the moment I think I'm running F7. BIOS, but there is now an F11, and so I'm going to update to that. I'm going to load optimum defaults, press yes, and then I'm going to restart again. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is press F8, or quick flash, and select yes, and then I'm going to update BIOS from drive, and then it's the HDD, and then as you can see there, F11, Z68, it's UD3, which is mine, so then I'm going to enter, reading BIOS file, are you sure to update BIOS? Enter to continue or escape to abort. Enter. Process data migration, erasing BIOS, blah 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 blah. So it's just, you know, doing its thing. Okay, press any key to continue, and now what I want to do is press escape. Are you sure to reset? Yes. So now, hopefully, fingers crossed, it will restart with the new BIOS. If it's gone correctly, which I hope it has. There's the beat. Keep on pressing delete. And I think this may be the new one, because before it did not say 1984 to 2011. BIOS version F11. Okay, so it seems to have worked. Which is good. All I'm gonna do now is just load optimum defaults, and then boot into Windows, just make sure everything's okay, and then I'll go back into the BIOS and change them back to my clock and voltage rates that I had them at last time. And hopefully all will be well. I have heard once doing this, if you open up CPU-Z and you change the V-core, it sometimes doesn't show, so this could be an issue, but I'll let you know what's happening in the comment section of my video, just telling you if it was all okay or if I had any problems. But thanks for watching. I hope I helped some people out there, you know, sort of have faith in updating their BIOS, and it's not going to be the end of the world. One last thing I will point out is I was originally trying to use a 1 terabyte external hard drive, USB, as a flash drive, and it just wouldn't have it because the file was the the device was just too big. Even when I tried to partition it, it was still having issues. So in the end, I just used my little 8 gigabyte memory stick, and then just changed it to a FAT32 system bootable drive, and then just copy and pasted the F11 file over to it, and yeah, as you can see, it's all worked fine. So yeah, again, cheers for watching. If you've got any comments or any questions, just let me know and I'll get back to you.